Welcome to the BankFirst Ranger Hour. Supertalk Mississippi 93.7 Spotlight on Northwest Community College. And you can listen to our live stream at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the BankFirst Ranger Hour. Now, here's your host, Gary Darby.
Happy Thursday, everyone. As you know, on this day, a Thursday, we do our BankFirst Ranger Hour. It's an August 22nd, 2024 edition of the program. We've got your weather forecast coming up. I'm going to give Jeff Foxworthy tickets away in just a matter of minutes, so I would continue to listen if I were you. And along the way, we always encourage you to text message in at 662-426-1093. 426-1093. If you're sitting down or you have the opportunity to text message very soon, safely, 426-1093 would be where I'm going to tell you to text. Not now. Hang on. On our show today, athletic discussion. Coaches will join us from the men's soccer program. Michael Sullivan is entering year three. We'll talk with Coach Sullivan first around 9:15, and then 9:30, it will be the volleyball coach, Allison Burchyett. She's starting her fifth season at NWCC, and we actually had to record this yesterday. I'll go ahead and tell you, because they were on a bus driving to the Dallas, Texas area to open up the season this afternoon. And so you'll hear that conversation coming up in the second half of the program when we're done. Got a few more things to remind you involving NWCC. Big goings on next week on campus. We'll get into other things in future shows and whatnot at the back end of the program. First thing I'm going to do before I get into our weather forecast is give a shout out to the couple that I met last night at the ballpark. Great conversation. And now you hear the voice here. You see the fat shorts guy with the little stubble on the face at the ballpark. That indeed was me. And I appreciate the conversation with you guys last night and you listening to this program as you did. In fact, this is the Northwest Community College program. This couple told me that their grandson went into the Northwest Community College lineman program. There's lots of great things you can do academically at Northwest Community College all throughout this 11-county area that they cover and this radio station, Supertalk 93.7, covers. Proud to meet some grandparents of a Ranger, and I hope you're having a good start to your Thursday. I'm sure we'll see one another at the ballpark again very, very soon. What a great forecast. Yes, it's going to get back into the 90s, but we woke up today and a little cool, right? Below 60 in the 50s at the early portion of our start. Right now, we're already working towards 70, and we'll get to around 91, 92 degrees. That's the exact same forecast for the next 2 days, Friday and Saturday, exactly the same. Sunshine and 91 for a high, and our low temperatures in the mid-60s. Decent weather, right? We'll get warm next week. We'll shove back up into the mid to upper 90s as we get into next week. But enjoy this the next few days. Get out and about. Do what you can do. In about 10 days, we'll finally see some rain, which we need as well. That weather forecast is a service of Discount Building and Home Center on Highway 6 West in Oxford. Your one-stop shop, whether it's building supplies, hardware, they've got the latest in home decor at the home center. You've got great weather to do a project in. 91 for the high today and sunny. Mid-60s overnight low. Rain coming in about 10 days. Discount Building and Home Center. Highway 6 West at Oxford. When you're coming in from the Batesville area, look over to the left right before Jackson Avenue. You'll find it. If you're coming out, obviously, the opposite direction, be on your right. Be careful. Be safe. And yes, again, here at the old Radio Palace, the sirens have been flying down Highway 6 again this morning. Drive safe out there, my people. Before we get into our discussion of men's soccer, Let's give away two tickets to see Jeff Foxworthy tomorrow night. I gave you the text message line at 662-426-1093. Simplest way for me to do this as I'm doing the program is to have you text message in. And I have to have the fastest person to do so on this Thursday. If you text message 662-426-1093 and you're the first to get that text message in, I've got two seats for you to see Jeff Foxworthy at the Heindel Center in Senatobia with special guest Tammy Pascatelli. It's that simple. 662-426-1093 text message and you will have an evening with Jeff Foxworthy and special guest Tammy Pascatelli tomorrow in Senatobia at the Heindel Center for the Performing Arts. I'll take a break. I'll let you know about our winner, but let's go ahead and do that. 662-426-1093. If you want to see Jeff Foxworthy, just text message into the program, and we will have two seats ready for you at the Heindel Center. Today we talk men's soccer with head coach Michael Sullivan next. A little bit later on, volleyball action. Regular season starts today. We'll get into that. And we also will let you know about our winner of our two tickets to see Jeff Foxworthy. We already have that located, and we'll pass along a name and location here in just a few. It is the BankFirst Ranger Hour. Thanks for being with us. Let's get it started.
BankFirst is proud to offer top-notch banking products like home, personal, and business loans, and perks earning checking accounts. BankFirst supports local businesses and people who support their communities. We believe our towns, no matter the size, deserve the best products and the best customer service, an experience we all deserve. We're hometown banking at its best. We're BankFirst. Do you bank with us? You should. BankFirst is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Are you ready to take your planting setup to the next level for less? Now through September 30th, Precision Planting is offering a $50 per row rebate on some of the most popular planter upgrades on the market. And better yet, you can stack the savings by buying more than one qualified product. Delta Precision Systems will put a customized quote together for you to make your next growing season the best one yet. To learn more about eligible Precision Planting products and get a quote, contact DeltaPrecisionSystems.com or phone 662-304-8470.
It's summertime, and you'll need the right ride to take in all the sights and sounds. Ross Motor Company in Senatobia has the newer low-mileage vehicle that fits your budget. Look online at rossmotor.net. Check out the newly redesigned 2025 Ram 1500 trucks for the fishing trip and the new two-row and three-row Jeep Grand Cherokees for the family getaway. Be ready for your next road adventure. Visit Ross Motor Company on Quality Lane in Senatobia or go to rossmotor.net.
And we are too. My name is Marvin Baird with Michigan Highway Patrol. As school has returned, we will be increasing all enforcement activities within school loading and unloading zones. This is your reminder that if the lights are flashing, don't come a passing.
Be sure to stop for buses when those lights are flashing. A special reminder from Supertalk Mississippi Media.
Northeast Mississippi Electric Power Association is locally owned, not-for-profit, and focused on our neighbors and communities we serve. We have a unique and special relationship because you are customers as well as our owners. At Northeast, we power not just homes and businesses, but also progress and potential for the future. We're here every day powering every aspect of life. Northeast Power, we're community-owned, community-built, community-builder.
Lately, your car does well to make it to the mailbox.
And it couldn't pass a turtle pushing a wheelbarrow.
You need to see your transmissions friend, Mo. Mo's Transmissions on Highway 7 South. Mo knows transmissions with over 30 years of experience in the business of keeping cars and trucks on the roads of North Mississippi. Mo's Transmissions is ready to serve. Say goodbye to transmission problems and say hello to Mo's Transmissions between Oxford and Water Valley on Highway 7 South.
This hour is everything Northwest. Your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College and powered by BankFirst. Thanks for joining us on the BankFirst Ranger Hour. Join the conversation now by texting 662-426-1093.
Welcome to another Ranger Hour. Gary Darby in the studios here in Supertalk 93.7. And, you know, let me be honest. Like, first of all, Andy in Oxford is the winner of our Jeff Foxworthy tickets. And we congratulate Andy and you all that tried to text message in and win. And Coach Michael Sullivan's on the phone. Coach, I got to be honest with you. I was text messaging back and forth. And then all of a sudden I realized I'm in the last commercial. I better call the coach. So I really haven't talked to you before we get on the air. So here we go, Coach. How are you this morning?
I'm doing well, ready to go. I got my radio face on.
Excellent. Well, I hope it's better than my radio face, you know? That's why I've been in this, as I say, been in this business for a long, long time. Jeff Foxworthy coming to Sitichobe tomorrow. You ready for the big night?
Oh, absolutely. I'm excited about that one. The blue-collar tour back in the day was awesome.
That's right. That's right. And so we congratulate Andy again in Oxford for winning a couple of tickets. He'll be at the Heindel Center. I hope that some of you out there listening will pack it with him. Coach Sullivan, welcome back to the show, and let's discuss the improvements that the men's soccer program has made under your leadership in the first 2 years. If you don't mind, just kind of think back with us and lead us through how you have taken the team, and then last year, two more wins in the regular season, three more in conference play. I don't know if saying baby steps is the right thing to say, but you are making those steps and progress in building this program.
Oh, yes, sir, absolutely. You know, the biggest thing that we wanted to get under control, not that it was super out of control, but we just kind of wanted to establish that culture. You know, I think it might sound like a repeat of last time I talked to you, but the culture was the biggest thing for me. And so, you know, we went and found a bunch of guys that kind of fit the mold of the culture that we wanted to establish. And, you know, even if I did absolutely zero coaching, with the culture established, we were going to get better. Obviously, I didn't do zero coaching, but that being said... That being said, you know, we did take those steps forward, and, you know, we had a lot of fight out of the guys last year. You know, you win some, you lose some, but the overall fight and the chemistry and how the guys worked together really pulled through, and we fought through some matches and won some matches that, you know, a lot of people say we weren't supposed to win. So that was a very exciting time for us, and ultimately we fought for a playoff spot all the way through the last game of the season. So that was major. That's major ground made from where we were at.
With that culture, I'm looking at your roster, and it looks like a good mix of guys you brought in from high school and some transfers in there to do that. Kind of explain, if you will, how you build that roster to fit the culture that you want.
Right. Well, it's obviously more than just I'm going to go watch you play and say, I like the way you play and you should come here. You know, it really takes that conversation or two to really kind of, you know, lift the veil, so to speak, understand kind of how somebody works. You know, it's obviously a job that you have to work with people a lot. And, you know, hopefully when you have those conversations with those players and with those players' parents, you get a real good feeling about, you know, what they're going to bring to the table. Obviously, you know from watching them on the field what they're going to bring to the field, but you really need to do that extra work to figure out, you know, overall the culture that they're going to bring to the team. And so I think that was a big part of what, you know, brings in the players that we kind of need. As far as the transfers go, you know, there were some players that, you know, wanted a different look at the game, and they reached out to me, and it was a conversation that I had with these players, and you know, you could tell that they were hungry. They wanted to get in. They wanted to change something, and I felt like we were the home for them. We brought them in, and they've done really, really well for us in the preseason, as brutal as preseason can be, you know?
Yeah, I would imagine in some of those triple-digit heat index days that running up and down the soccer field can be a challenge, and to get through that. And with that, let's talk about what you have witnessed so far in your exhibition play. What have you liked, Coach?
Overall, I've really enjoyed, number one, just the amount of fight that this group has. Outside of tactically speaking, the amount of fight that this group has is just incredible. You know, we've had quite a few different moments in all of our games so far that just, you know, haven't gone our way. You know, every dog has its day kind of deal. And, you know, when we're going through those moments, this team has not faltered from what we're trying to get done. It may be a little bumpy here and there, but you know, they stay with it. They put their head down. They get the job done, or they fight through until they can get that kind of momentum back to get that job done. And it's been a pleasure to watch, and it's been an honor to coach these guys so far. Coach, and I'm really looking forward to getting in the conference and hopefully shocking quite a few people.
Coach Sullivan with us for a few more minutes. You've got to have that man tending the net. So if you don't mind, tell us about your goalkeepers and who will try and, you know, give you that opportunity to win some of these matches.
Yeah, absolutely. So we have two goalkeepers that are fighting it out right now. One is a goalkeeper from St. Joseph Catholic Church. We all call him Fritz, but his name's John Barber. But he's coming in as a freshman out of high school, and he's fighting for a spot. And he's helping, you know, keep the competitive keeper going as far as an inner keeper. And then we have also a keeper from Delta State who's originally from Hernando. His name is Jacob Little, and he brings, you know, obviously competition to the keeper position, and he's also a transfer from Delta State who we were able to pick up over the summer. And he's somebody, as well as Fritz, that we're both looking at them to push each other and kind of anchor down the net for the teams, because, you know, every single team is going to have a mishap, and you don't always want your keepers to bail you out. But I think both of those guys are doing a good job of pushing the envelope and saying, hey guys, if you mess up, you can count on me. And, you know, that's just the ultimate safety, so to speak, in football terms, in case your defense messes up. And we're really excited to have those guys backing us up.
Is there a returner or two that you would like to mention that are in some of the other positions on the pitch for you that we can get their names out to the public as well?
Yeah, I would I would love to give a shout out to Cody Smothers. He's been with us for a while for, you know, just the overall effort and commitment that he's got to the program. And hopefully he can give us what he wants to give us and, you know, help propel this group forward. And, you know, I also have to give a shout out to both of my guys from Florida making the long haul again back up here. They seem to be in the mood where they want to push the team forward and give us a good advantage going into the conference season. You know, both of those guys are doing really well for us so far, and I want to make sure that they know they're wanted as well, and if they have a prime opportunity to help the team. You know, that's going to be Will Waltrip and Miller Thorson. Both of those guys are going to bring experience, leadership, and overall good culture to the team. I could go on for days for different guys I want to give shout outs to.
Sure.
But, you know, those are the ones that I can think of so far.
I know you have the schedule shows another exhibition later on, but you actually open up the regular season on Saturday, right? Tell us a little bit about Mineral Area College and what your team is looking at when they get this thing started.
Yeah, so Mineral Area is they've been known for a long time for being a very competitive junior college team. And, you know, it's a really good test for us. They come in with a very large international roster, and, you know, it presents its different difficulties, you know, kind of navigating the water, so to speak, when you're playing against people from other countries who play this sport. You know, the sport's different in every single country. And so it's going to be a very good test for us in order to kind of recognize the different ways that different people play this game. And, you know, I expect a lot of intensity. I expect good ball movement. And, you know, we took them to a 3-2 game. We lost to them last year. But, you know, that being said, we've gotten a lot better since last year. And I'm excited to see the overall battle that we're going to give them. You know, I think I'm really thinking their eyes are going to be opened. I don't want to jinx anything here, but I think it should be a pretty good game.
Well, we encourage you to get out and watch it Saturday at 7. With that, so you have today and you have tomorrow. You were talking about the goalkeepers and those that are fighting for spots. Do you have difficult challenges to put that lineup out there on Saturday? Is there still, you know, your players have a couple of days to try and say, I want to start that game on Saturday night?
Oh, this year is unbelievably difficult when it comes to trying to figure out, you know, who's going to be where on game day. You know, this team is a lot deeper than we were in years prior, and, you know, that brings a lot of good things to the table, as in making sure that each guy knows, hey, you know, I'm going to have to fight for this, you know. So when it comes to the lineups of the different games, I think there's a couple things we have to take into consideration. You know, since we're so deep, who's had the better week in sessions? You know, which players match up against what the opponent has better? You know, who overall in the past few games has earned that? You know, it's going to be a lot more complicated this year as far as making sure that we have the right lineup on the field. And it's probably going to be a cyclical starting lineup for this season, just because we're a good bit deeper. And, you know, I think we're very fortunate and blessed to be in the situation to where we have that option available. I mean, it's just a good group of guys. That's the bottom line. And I'm super excited to kind of see, you know, the different things that these guys can bring to the table. And I can say this to close that one out. You know, nothing's off the table as far as who's going to be in what spot come game day.
Excellent. Coach, a great conversation with you. I enjoyed it. I am going to be at some point Tuesday around Meet the Rangers. Our afternoon program, Sports Talk Mississippi, is coming for a statewide chance to talk to the entire state of Mississippi at Meet the Rangers from 3 to 6, and I hope to be over there. And finally, put my face to your face and other coaches that I've been talking to on these shows for several years now. Thanks for being with us today.
Yeah, thank you, Gary. It was a pleasure.
All right. We discussed men's soccer there with the coach, Michael Sullivan. Year 3 for him, steady progression each and every year. He likes the depth, obviously, and the competitive work that it will be to find that lineup and get ready, as the season will start officially for them with a regular season game on Saturday night at 7 against number 12 Mineral Area College. Then they have an exhibition game again. They've already played two. They'll have Tougaloo come in on Monday night. And then they start playing teams from Mississippi and other teams from across the country. With Colin, number 3 Northeast Nebraska, they'll play different teams in Senatobia and going into Alabama a little bit before getting into conference play against number 16 Jones on Tuesday, September 17. Meet the Rangers Day is Tuesday night, 7 o'clock. Sports Talk Mississippi will be there live from 3 until 6. And at some point, I'm going to be over there as well and just kind of hang out and visit and, as I said, maybe get a chance to see some of these coaches that I've never laid eyes on but have talked with on this program. Meet the Rangers night is Tuesday at 7. It will be at Bobby Franklin Field, of course. Admission is free for the event. They'll recognize members of the rodeo, the volleyball, football, men and women's soccer, men and women's golf, the cheerleaders, the dance team, and the Ranger Marching Band will be there and will perform a little bit. Some small little blurbs, some snippets, if you will, of their performance that will be the halftime look you see when football season gets started. Thank you, Coach Sullivan, for being with us again today. And regular season begins this weekend. The volleyball regular season starts today. I had a chance as they were driving to Irving, Texas, to talk to the head coach, Allison Burchyett. We'll listen to that interview next.
Show for you, and it's called Delta Rising. Coming to Oxford, one night only. Taking over the Powerhouse Theater Friday, August 23rd. Come be a part of this one-of-a-kind music and cultural experience, featuring food, art, and world-famous musicians from all over the Delta. I'm talking music, I'm talking hot tamales, I'm talking fried catfish, I'm talking soul food, and a tribute to the music of the Tangents. All for one admission. Tickets at oxfordarts.com. Take a trip to the Delta without leaving the square. Delta Rising, brought to you by Indianola Tourism, Delta Pride Catfish, Community Bank, Cathead Distillery, Red Panther Brewing, The Blue Biscuit, and Mississippi Arts Commission.
76% of online local searches result in a phone call or visit. But is your information correct? 86% of business listings on the web have inaccuracies and missing data. We can fix that for you. Hi, this is Rick Mize, Market Manager for Supertalk Mississippi Media. Would you like to get a report card on how you're doing on the internet highway? Simply go to stmmdigital.com, click on the free demo for a free assessment of your digital presence. Supertalk Mississippi Media is helping businesses across the state and North Mississippi reach their customers and prospects. We offer services from website design to optimization products and targeted display advertising, including retargeting, geofencing, first-party addressable. Reach out to any Supertalk Mississippi Media representative to get started. You can reach me, R. Mize, at supertalk.fm. Or go to our stmmdigital.com site and ask for a free assessment and get started on your digital journey today.
An evening with legendary comedian Jeff Foxworthy.
But they have a rule in my neighborhood. If you walk your dog and your dog does his business in somebody else's yard, you need to get a little plastic bag, pick it up, and dispose of it. So you drive through my neighborhood and there's all these attractive women walking around with poo-poo purses.
Jeff Foxworthy, Friday, August 23rd, 7:30 p.m. The Heindel Center for the Performing Arts in Senatobia, Mississippi. Special guest, Tammy Pascatelli. Tickets at heindelcenter.org.
Bolin Air Conditioning and Heating and Oxford is dedicated to providing the best possible solution for your home or business. Worrying about your air conditioning system is a waste of time. That's why Bolin Air Conditioning keeps the worry away by offering free estimates on new Trane systems. We love our customers, so emergency service is available if you need a repair. Visit us online at bolinacandheat.com or Facebook at Bolin AC and Heat, or call Travis Huebner at 662-897-9853. It's hard to stop a train.
Ellison Assisted Living of Oxford combines expert care with active social lifestyles to meet you at any stage of life. We believe that life is meant to be lived as vibrantly as possible. For your assisted living needs, we offer individualized adaptive care plans, lifestyle programming, chef-prepared meals, and social opportunities for seniors. We're dedicated to ensuring our residents thrive each and every day. Visit ellisonoxford.com to schedule a tour of Ellison Assisted Living of Oxford and experience the best in senior living.
Roz Music Center is the perfect place for musicians, beginner or pro, to find the right instrument, amp, sound system, or accessory. Cables, adapters, straps, picks, and so much more. Roz Music Center, Midtown Shopping Center in Oxford, 662-234-0051.
Thanks for listening to the Bank First Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Supertalk Mississippi 93.7 and streaming live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Bank First Ranger Hour.
Second half of our program, it is the Bank First Ranger Hour. In full disclosure, catching up with Coach Allison Burchyett of the volleyball team on a bus headed to Texas. On a Wednesday, actually. So, Coach, you got the front seat. You're looking out the big windows. You taking in all the sights?
Definitely. We just had a couple young ladies that had never been to Arkansas. So they got to mark that off their list of things to do. So, always having a good time here.
Well, we're going to get into that a little bit with the roster and things, because there are several freshmen on there that are probably, you know, taking their first trip, you just said, to a different state, but the first real trip they might get into in the athletic world. Let's go back a season ago, if you don't mind. 28-17, finished in the Region 23 tournament. Your volleyball program is taking its steps probably to getting where you want. Do you agree or disagree with that statement?
Definitely, Gary. I mean, we wanted to win 20 matches or more last year, and we far surpassed that by winning 28. So very proud of the program and the direction it's going. And also, we were the MAC all-academic team for last year. So as a coach, I mean, the girls are working hard on the court and the classroom and becoming very successful young women as well. So all good things.
And then you're starting to see them leave you and your program and go to four-year schools, and now that development and relationship is going as well.
Correct. We had five young ladies that moved on from last year's team to play at four-year colleges and universities. So, again, you know, the future is bright. If they want to continue to play, we want to put them in a position to play at the next level as well.
So you mentioned, right, you're traveling, you're going to Irving, Texas, and we'll get to those matches in a moment. And a couple of players had never been through the state of Arkansas. They're getting an opportunity to see that now. Expand on the roster. I know in community college world, it rotates. There's heavy turnover, but you've got a lot of your roster or freshmen, is that correct?
Correct. We added 10 new freshmen, a new sophomore, so 11 total new players. We have five returning players from last year. So it's a lot of new faces for Northwest Volleyball this year, but it's been a great experience so far. We had the full 2 weeks for preseason, and we're able to play both our alumni in a scrimmage and then Frontier College, Illinois, two matches last Saturday in a scrimmage. So we've got some good experience already, and we're hopefully going to play well when we hit Dallas Northlake tomorrow and also play Northeast Oklahoma.
As you've continued this program and it has gotten better and it's won more games, are you finding it maybe easier now to step out of state? I know you've got great teams that are local, and we all as listeners and fans want our local young ladies on this team, but are you finding that it's easier for you to step out of the state of Mississippi now and bring in some talent as well?
Yes. So we've got our five out-of-state players. And, of course, we're right on the border with Tennessee and Arkansas, and we even have a young lady from Illinois on our team that's only 3 hours from home. So We're kind of in a great position to, you know, get kids that are out-of-state. I mean, we've got kids from the Memphis area, which, you know, they're within an hour of being home from Senatobia. So when we say we've got out-of-state kids, we do, but a lot of them aren't really that far. We've got a young lady from Jonesboro, Arkansas, who's not far from home, right there on the border with Arkansas. So we've got kids that are out-of-state, but they're still not very far from home.
What did you see from those exhibitions and your takeaways, whether it was good and you like what you saw, or some things that you've practiced on since to be prepared for this season opener?
Yes, I mean, when we played our alumni the first Saturday on the 10th, you know, we were able to find some weaknesses in our offense and our defense that we worked on for the following week. And this past Saturday, the 17th, when we played Frontier, two full matches, we swept them in six sets, which is pretty good because Frontier is a good program, and we actually lost to them once last year. So I'm very pleased with that and their progress from the first scrimmage date to the second scrimmage date. And then we've had a couple of days, you know, since that scrimmage, Monday and Tuesday, and then we practiced this morning before we got on the bus today, Wednesday, to kind of work on some stuff to get ready for tomorrow.
And you open up with a nationally ranked team in Dallas College, North Lake, and then Northeastern Oklahoma A&M. Obviously a big challenge for you right out of the gate.
Definitely. I think it's great to play good programs early. That's how you kind of see what you need to work on before you get into conference play. And I'm excited to head into a conference now that will have six teams, and we'll have at least nine in 2025. So Mississippi volleyball is growing as well.
Yeah, that's where I wanted to go next, and then kind of finish up, is the fact that, you know, we saw a new program in Northeast open up, and then now you're starting to get others, right? Meridian is joining in. Who else is joining in this season?
Jones will be our sixth team that we'll have for this season for 2024.
Doesn't that excite you as a coach of the sport and watching it grow from your area, which is the top of the state, to the bottom of the state, and trying to draw more schools in? I know that's important to you as a coach and to these players as well.
It definitely is. You know, having been a Mississippi volleyball coach in high school and college now for 25 years, it's really neat to see the growth and, you know, see these young ladies have more opportunities to play after high school that want to. And then, of course, just the rivalries in the state are growing stronger and stronger, and that just makes volleyball and just the sports experience so much better.
I'm going to let you go and continue with your ride, but having a friend who has a daughter going through high school who's playing this sport, and the fact that I know growing up, being involved in baseball, that there are tournaments all over the place and that, you know, there are teams in Mississippi that are moving and going, and he was telling about his daughter and the fact that, you know, there's now great opportunity for the young ladies to get out, and I think they spent a big weekend in St. Louis and doing different things. A lot of your roster, I would assume, has been on some of those, you know, travel and elite teams along the way as well.
Correct. And you know, I've coached those competitive, you know, high school teams as well. We call them club volleyball. And, you know, and a lot of my current players on the Northwest team have played that. And it's fun, and you get to travel, you get to see the country, you get to go to the coast, you get to go to St. Louis, as you said, New Orleans, you know, all kinds of different places. But there's something even more special, Gary, I think, about putting a school name on your jersey,
yeah,
too. I mean, those experiences are really cool, but there's a different kind of level of pride when you play for your college or you play for your school team.
Well, I appreciate you giving us some time. You get this started tomorrow with those first two matches. Best of luck with that throughout the season, and we'll catch up with you later on in the year, okay?
All right, very good. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. That is the volleyball coach at Northwest, Allison Burchyett, on with us on a bus driving on a Wednesday. And, of course, their matches and season begin today. All right, so it is a couple of matches against the 12th-ranked team in the country, Dallas College North Lake, the host. That's at 2, and then at 4 o'clock, Northeastern Oklahoma A&M College. I encourage you to keep up. NWCCRangers.com, Brian Lentz and company do a great job of keeping you up to date. Find out how that Ranger volleyball team does as they get the season started this afternoon at 2. All right. It is time to take a break, come back, do more. It's the BankFirst Ranger Hour.
Hometown Bank. BankFirst is proud to offer top-notch banking products like home, personal, and business loans, and perks earning checking accounts. BankFirst supports local businesses and people who support their communities. We believe our towns, no matter the size, deserve the best products and the best customer service, an experience we all deserve. We're hometown banking at its best. We're BankFirst. Do you bank with us? You should. BankFirst is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Highland Hills Medical Center in Senatobia is your outpatient testing destination, offering the latest in technology, including full-service laboratory, CAT scans, x-rays, mammograms, ultrasounds, and bone density scans. You can receive high-quality service close to home. We understand the value of quality care and will work with your local provider to keep you healthy. Find out more at highlandhillsmc.com. Highland Hills Medical Center, our community, our hospital.
This is Jane Burkhart from Starboard Vacations. Experience the ultimate Caribbean luxury, all-inclusive vacation at Sandals and Beaches Resorts. As a preferred Sandals Beaches agency, our professional travel planning services are free to our clients. We can help find the best Sandals or Beaches resort and room category that fits your budget. Starboard Vacations office is in Hernando. Call 662-429-1000 for help with your Sandals vacation.
Why choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
Can I make my side softer?
Can I make my side firmer whenever I want?
Can we sleep cooler?
Sleep Number does that. Cools up to 8 times faster and lets you choose your ideal comfort on either side. 94% of Sleep Number smart sleepers report better sleep. J.D. Power ranks Sleep Number number one in customer satisfaction with mattresses purchased in-store. And now, during our biggest sale of the year, save 50% on the Sleep Number limited edition smart bed. Limited time. For J.D. Power 2023 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards. To find a store near you, visit sleepnumber.com.
One thing they don't make enough of is time. Never enough in a day. If you are pressed for time but still want to eat great, you are in luck at the Oxford Junction. With their new mobile app, you can order ahead of time, skip the wait, and be on your way with a delicious meal. Plus, when you order online or on the app, get a free cooling cup. Go to oxfordjunction.toast.site or download the app today. The Oxford Junction, located at 550 MS on Highway 7 South.
Support for the Manor Heights Chiefs is made possible by the generous support of our sponsors, BankFirst, State Farm, Way Good, Pride of the Pond, Big Penguin Ice, Mississippi Land Bank, All Animal Hospital, Benchmark Auto, and KCK CPA. Let's show our sponsors some love and cheer on the Chiefs all season long.
Chiefs fans, be sure to thank these great business partners. We hope to see you on the Hill this fall. Go Chiefs!
Give the gift of fun with Premier Lanes Entertainment Center, located next door to Malco Oxford Common Cinema. The area's largest family fun center features bowling, action alley arcade, birthday parties, events, and more. Book your fun today at PremierLanes.com.
Thanks for listening to the Bank First Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Supertalk Mississippi 93.7 and streaming live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Bank First Ranger Hour.
And anywhere you find your podcast later, this program will be out and about. In case you missed, our two great guests today, men's soccer coach Michael Sullivan, and the volleyball coach, Allison Burchyett. Good info on both programs. Excited about the direction of both. The entire Northwest Athletic Department, led by great men and women, with good young men and women, both on their field and off their field of play. We've discussed in past shows grade point averages and how good that has been, especially in the football situation. Having some of the highest GPAs in the country. Proud to have that, as well as currently being preseason number 7. We hope to have Coach Benji Parker on very soon, and we have that football season ready to begin with Northwest coming up in the next couple of weeks. But good discussion with Coach Sullivan. Men's soccer team again Saturday night, 7 o'clock. Mineral Area College. They're on the Northwest Community College campus in Senatobia. And for the women's volleyball team, today in action in Irving, Texas, beginning at 2 o'clock with a couple of matches there. We can update you on all of that on next Thursday's program. Shout out to Bank First for being a part of it as well, helping us each and every Thursday power this program to you between 9 and 10. And we also give another nod to Andy of Oxford, first person to text message into the program. Andy and someone else will be amongst the people at the Heindel Center for the Performing Arts tomorrow to see Jeff Foxworthy. We have other seats and things we'll be passing along to you as shows come up in Senatobia and the Heindel Center. You can go to heindelcenter.org to find out more or to get what tickets might be available still for an evening with Jeff Foxworthy and special guest Tammy Pascatelli. Next up on the docket is Lee Greenwood with special guest Brian White. We'll have some seats to give away to that event, which is September the 7th. Shrek the Musical is coming up on October the 2nd. And then you can just go and look at the events and see the rest of the fall schedule as it makes a great and easy place to go and find some great acts and then musicals and then movies if you're looking for things like that. And it's always a great gift idea. Maybe you can still get some tickets and a package or a gift card or whatever it might be to help out a loved one go see some of the people they might want in the entertainment industry. Heindel Center for the Performing Arts doing a great job of bringing people into the North Mississippi area. Blake Bostic running that, and we appreciate the opportunity to pass along a couple of seats to see Jeff Foxworthy. He's in Senatobia tomorrow. Speaking of tomorrow, it becomes the Roberts Wilson PA High School Sports Hour, and on that program, we will get into some high school football discussion with Water Valley head coach Clint Faust. He'll be on with us first. When we say goodbye to him, we'll immediately start talking with Marshall Academy head coach Ben Durham. For our MAIS schools, the private schools in the North Mississippi area, this will be week two for some, including the Marshall Academy Patriots. Others will be getting their season started this week. For our MHSAA public schools, scrimmages and jamborees going on. I'll pass along some of the places in North Mississippi that you can see some high school football on tomorrow's program. And Jake Thompson is scheduled to come in the studio because college football does begin. We call it week zero. The very first game will be overseas in Ireland between Florida State and Georgia Tech. A couple of ACC teams putting it together out on the road, far away from home, and getting our college football season started. So we'll have a lot to do on tomorrow's program, and I hope you join us along the way. What an awesome-looking day. We have sunshine. It will creep a little bit above 90 today. We'll get back into the 91, 92-degree range for the next 2 to 3 days, and we'll beef it back up. Sunday around 95. By the time we get to Tuesday and Wednesday, 97. And then by next weekend, we'll welcome September with about a 50% chance of rain. So enjoy what we have, and then we'll enjoy that rain as well, because looking at the old Bermuda in the front yard, it needs all the help it can get. All right, my friends, remember that Sports Talk Mississippi will be in Senatobia for your Northwest Ranger listeners on Tuesday at Meet the Rangers from 3 until 6. The actual event itself will start at 7, so a lot will be going on in the Northwest Community College campus with Supertalk Radio and a lot of special guests along the way. I'm going to be there at some point just to see some of you good people in the Senatobia area as well. Next, we'll get to Gerard, go back to West Point and our statewide programs and what they are doing today as Middays and Sports Talk Mississippi are live at the Growth Alliance in West Point and talking about the upcoming Prairie Arts Festival on Labor Day weekend. So all of that's coming up the rest of the way on Supertalk Radio 93.7. We are finished for the day. Off we go. We'll let Middays take you next, and we'll do a Roberts Wilson PA tomorrow. The high school hour comes your way between 9 and 10. Thanks as always. You know how to get in touch with the program. We'll do it again and hope you're with us on a Friday. Till then, so long.
Sure that next time we'll have-